Streatham merged with Marlborough in 2003. But previous to that, yeah, I was with Streatham Cricket Club, and I've been involved since 1962. Long time.
Got our battery, have you?
Needs an MOT.
We'll see you next week.
Cheers.
Cricket is the chess of all games. You know, it's an individual sport played in a team. It takes a lot of thought, a lot of skill. It's not a game that is easy to take up, but we really don't mind how good you are.
Come on, Sam!
A lot of people drive past you. You will never know there's a cricket club here.
We cater for ladies cricket, colts cricket, and hopefully with the right facilities we can get disabled cricketers here as well.
Third in the league, warming off the top, Paddington. They're lower down the league, but don't take them for granted. Hit the bad ball.
Which professional cricketer do you compare yourself to?
I'd probably say Stuart Broad.
What's the plan, guys?
Smash.
Well, you don't have senior cricket, you don't have international cricket, you don't have grassroots cricket. You know, Alistair Cook and Ben Stokes, you know, have got to start somewhere.
Guys, we're on 80.
And that progression, if it's not in the schools and increasingly in state schools, it's not, then club cricket has to teach them the game.
Catch it! Yeah!
Yeah! I've got a whole new social life out of it. I mean, the girls are fantastic. Earlier this year in February, we went on tour to Trinidad and Tobago.
How many runs did you get?
30.
What does cricket mean to you?
A lot. Sexy. Like, if I'm upset or something, cricket, like, boosts me. Why is it? Makes me feel better when I do good in cricket.
Well, I work very hard between Monday and Friday and weekends, so this is my outlet, this is my life, my passion. Once you play cricket, and once it's in your bloodstream, you can never get it out.
This club has been great to me over the years. My children have grown up at the club, my two boys. The second one was nearly born at the club. Karen, my wife, passed away recently. And she looked after the... She done the teas. It's always been a very friendly club. I thoroughly enjoyed my time up here immensely.
My immediate family are in Malta. I've got a very, very small family over here. So the club for me is my immediate family here. Seeing people that I love and care, it's just nice. It's just a nice hub to be. And being here is like, it's like paradise, really.
What would you do if you didn't have cricket?
Probably wouldn't be here. I might be in the box. I just can't imagine myself not doing anything but cricket.
I love umpiring, always have done. I'll carry on till they carry me out in a coffin.
Thank God that cricket is what I do and love. Oh.
What we're trying to do is become a very inclusive, very social club. The problem we're having at the moment is that the cricket is being left behind because of the facilities that we have.
We have a clubhouse that's falling down, but we're working hard at sort of trying to resolve that and raise money for a new clubhouse.
We could do with a brand new kitchen, soon as poss, because all the doors are falling off.
If we don't have a new pavilion soon, then it really puts the club at threat.
Guys, we need one!
We need to invest in this club, or it won't be here.
Yes, Alex!
We do have many, many challenges, not least of which is the clubhouse and keeping us financially solvent. But there's such energy here, there's such a love for the club, that it goes on year and year and gets more and more impressive. We're setting the scene for a club that will be here in another 50 years.
You should be really proud of yourself. It's been a really good season, so round of applause.
You wouldn't be happy for the rest of the week. If you want to get into cricket, it's the best place to come.